Hi everybody, Alex Aploy here from Expert Forex, and in today's video we're going to be looking at how you can make a good Forex robot even better. And you're going to be seeing an alternative to the optimization process of finding settings that make your EA more profitable. Now today's analysis is going to be about the Forex Dream Machine. It carries a 30-day money-back guarantee, but it is also ideal for beginner traders because it's a true set and forget EA. And what's also particularly good is that it's US trader friendly. There are no FIFO or hedging complications with this particular EA. It's in fact almost the ideal EA because it is also profitable. Now, I'm not going to go into how this EA works in a lot of detail. There's a lot of information out there on other videos. I'll give you the link to the playlist of Dream Machine videos. But essentially, if you look on your screen, you'll see that this is a representation of the strengths and weaknesses of currencies. And all that this EA does is it trades the strong currencies against the weak currencies because those conditions cannot be maintained. And sooner or later, the strong ones will become normal again. And the weak ones will become normal again, and that in fact creates a great trading opportunity. Now here's the playlist. The link to this playlist will be in the description of the video and also in the first commentary of the video. But go and have a look at it. We've had webinars, we've had training sessions and all that. It is a very simple EA, and in fact when you purchase this EA, you get a plug and play version. You don't even have to study any of the trading or training or anything. The plug and play version is literally you plug it in, and there are essentially only three settings that you have to decide on: which time frame you want to use, which approach, aggressive, conservative or balanced, and how much you want to risk on your trades. Only three settings and you're off, you're trading. And then the good news is you can set and forget it. You can just leave it alone. Those set and forget versions are updated through the process I'm going to be showing you right now. So at the moment, we're trading four versions of the Dream Machine. There are three being traded on the 1 hour and three being traded on the 4 hour basis. And then there's a conservative, balanced and aggressive version in each time frame. Very easy. And on your screen, you can see the results of the total portfolio. They've been trading for over 270 days. And you can see the results on average 15% up, which is not too bad. Nicely up. It could be a lot better. You will see why. Let's have a look at the details of the best performing account. Okay, if we'll have a look at this account, the results are much better. 38% return over about a 10-month period. Not a bad return. I would take that any day. But as you can see, this account actually battled for the first few months. For the first 8 months, it battled, and we reviewed the settings, got a bit of success there, had a bit of a downward activity, and has gone up again. And we are now looking for even better settings based on how we're progressing with our settings changes as we go along. Now, just looking at these results right now and looking at the other results that you can get from FX Blue, we can see that the winning rate is 62%. We want to get that a little bit higher, so we want to get the winning rate up a little bit. Then the average win is lower than the average loss. Now, if we could get the average one higher than the average loss, then that would be ideal. So already we're getting clues at the changes we need to make to our settings because we're getting this feedback from the market. Now, the biggest feedback actually comes from the charts. Now, I will zoom in and make this chart a lot clearer. It's not very clear, but it is very important that you see the trades that have taken place made by the EA on the charts so that you can do the type of analysis that I'm going to do right now, because that gives you a lot of ideas about what could be going wrong and what could be going right with the trading. So let's go through these transactions one by one. So I'm going to start with, and what I've done here is I've just loaded the Aussie Yen transactions. It's had a good success rate, the Aussie Yen. I want to have a look at why the gains are smaller than the losses. So we need to correct that. And also just want to evaluate the existing settings. So let's have a look at their first transaction. Now, on your screen, the first transaction is that sell over there, but it also at the same time tells you that is where the stop is and that is where the target is. And immediately the first idea that I get here is that the stop and the target are way too big. That's the first thing that I get, the impression I get. The other thing that I get is that their relationship is not right. You've got this huge stop over there and you've got the small target. And that is why we're getting smaller gains than we're getting than the losses that occur. So the first thing I have to bear in mind is that I'm going to make the stop losses a lot smaller and correct the relationship between the target and the stop loss. All right, so you can already see that we're gaining a lot of information by looking at the trades on the charts. And then if we look at the next trade, there it is again, that's a buy, big stop, small target. But the other thing that stands out now is that the targets are too big. The price is not reaching the target. And the only reason why these transactions are going positive is because there's a trailing stop in place. The other thing that you will notice here is that many transactions actually change direction. And I'll show you why that is in the actual settings. But here's the sell. It went down and cashed in and immediately opened a buy. And that buy started out. It was positive, went up, and then cashed in and opened a sell immediately. And then it went down again. And in this case, it didn't open a buy. It doesn't always happen in that particular way. But that is one of the things that you'll notice that happens often when you're using the Dream Machine. So the other thing is that it looks like the price generally moves in the right direction when it starts trading, but targets are too big and they often don't reach the targets. Also, the cash ins and switch arounds happened a little bit too early. Ideally, we want them to happen a little bit later. Like that buy would have been nice at that point rather than where it was now. And so we're going to fool around with the settings to get those kind of things right. So as we go through the transactions, you can see successful there, successful there, successful there. Then nothing much happened. And that's what happens with the Dream Machine. If there's no particular trade that occurs, then nothing much will happen. Then we had another successful buy here. And but then nothing much happened here. And then here was a buy quite early. Again, we're entering some of the transactions too early, as I mentioned earlier. So we want to enter a little bit later. That was just successful, but entry might have been a bit too early. And then again, there was a switch around from the buy to a sell, and that was successful, the buy there, and just successful. And then the sell was successful. Again, the target was way too big for that sell. And then you had a buy, again successful, but the target was too big for that. And I will see why these early cash-ins are happening. Then up here, a buy was signaled and only a very small gain was made. And then we went through a whole period here where nothing was traded. Now, just bear in mind, we're trading 28 currencies. The Dream Machine takes the absolutely best currency and trades that. So the Aussie yen may not have been the best currency to trade over that particular period. And then here's another buy that went successful. Again, the target was way too big. There's a sell that went successful, and there was the cash in. Again, the target was way too big. But interestingly enough, look how the stop had moved from the entry point to halfway to the current price action. So there's the following stop happened there. So just reviewing this basic chart has helped me identify a lot of adjustments that I need to make to the setting. And I've mentioned most of those adjustments. So let's have a look at the settings of the Dream Machine. And I'm going to go through the detailed one, not the set and forget version, but the detailed version. Okay, so here is a summary of the settings. And the first setting that I'll need to look at is the entry difference level. So the entry difference level says how big must the difference be between the strongest currency and the weakest currency. And it's just in values. And previously it was 55. I've now made it 60. So in other words, it's going to be more difficult to get to that level. The entries will become a little bit later, and you could actually use stops that are a little bit smaller because the entries are becoming a little bit later. So that's the first adjustment that I would make to my settings. Then the second adjustment is you can do the opposite. So if you want to enter on a difference of 60, you can also exit when they cross over and the difference becomes a minus 60. So effectively you have a minus situation where what was strong before becomes weak and the difference becomes that big. So minus 60 is a great setting, because just think about this. You could never have a FIFO or a hedging problem, because if you're at minus 60, it will open a trade in the opposite direction. And as we've seen on the chart, that's what in fact happens. So you open a sell, let's say, it goes and it becomes minus 60, it then will open. It will close the buy and it will open the sell. So that's how you can get rid of the danger of hedging and FIFO. Then the other thing that I've changed tremendously is the size of the stops. I've almost halved them, and I've made the ratio between the stop and the target a lot closer. I haven't made it equal yet. I've made it a lot closer, and let's see what results come out of that. Then the other thing is I've adjusted my trailing stop to go in accordance with the smaller target levels that have been created, and I have basically eliminated the dynamic stop and the dynamic target, because the following stop and the exit difference level seem to be playing a much bigger role in those exits. So there we are. Six changes have come out of my analysis of the FX Blue information and of the chart information. And that I would suggest to who trades Forex Robots, this is the approach that you should be taking, not a re-optimization approach. You can do the re-optimization approach. I can give you guidance to help you with the changes I've made here, but you could also just use your trading common sense and logic to make these changes. Now, just again, if you do not own the Dream Machine, you can buy it from the link that will be in the commentary or in the description of the video. Also, it is part of a bundle where we sell 17 of our EAs for 81% discount. The other way you can purchase the EA is part of the Cyber Monday bundle. This bundle was received so well that we decided to continue it as a permanent offer to clients. You can buy the Make Money EA, the Dream Machine EA, and the Grid Trend Multiplier EA, our top three EAs, for a 60% discount using this offer. Now let's quickly run through the learning points of this video. Firstly, a results review is what I personally find much more effective than a re-optimization. You need to see the robot trades on an actual chart so that you can understand what's going on and possibly get guidance towards setting change. Always use the FX Blue information that it provides, the analysis. They provide the most amazing analysis. I've got a few videos on them. You can just Google or search on YouTube for those. FX Blue provides the most amazing information regarding Forex Robot trading when you link your account to it. Then the next point is you have to monitor your accounts regularly to make sure that they're not running away from you because of bad settings, but also to find better and better settings. And this monitoring shouldn't be too often. Every 3 weeks, every 3 to 5 weeks will be plenty. Rather look for excuses not to make changes than to make changes, because the EA needs freedom to work and trade. The other thing is to experiment. When you are unsure about the settings, create 3 or even 9 demo accounts to trade different variations of the settings. Trade them for a month and see how they go. Don't be scared of experimenting. That's the way we get to those settings that are really powerful and produce really good returns. Now, the other learning point is if the settings that we've used so far are so bad, and you can see they're not the greatest settings ever, it means that this EA has the most amazing potential to be an exceptional EA. Now, I hope you found this video interesting and educational, and that it's given you a few ideas about Forex robot trading. The Dream Machine should be your number one choice when selecting a set and forget EA. From me, Alex Deploy, cheerio.